It was 40 years ago this week, a crime rattled the small town of Fairhaven outside St. Cloud. So much so that the people who live there are still afraid to talk about it. Jennifer Hoff reports on the unsolved murder of Myrtle Cole and why the lead investigator is so confident he's going to solve this case.
Fairhaven, Minnesota is a small town that harbors a big mystery.
That seems weird for Fairhaven. Something so bad happened right there on the corner.
40 years ago, Myrtle Cole was murdered in her own home, long since torn down, a new one now in its place, left only with old photos rarely seen before, showing a door wide open, glass on the floor, just two doors down from Carol Schmidt.
Not even safe in your locked home.
A young mother at the time who said Cole mostly kept to herself.
Walked onto the store for her groceries about once a week. We'd wave at each other and she'd say hi.
The 81-year-old widow lived alone, reportedly with no running water, relying only on Social Security. The evidence of what happened December 12, 1981.
Almost this entire row.
Packed away in boxes in the basement of the Stearns County Sheriff's Office, full of clues, but no clear answers about who committed the crime.
The only motivation that we can come up with is like a drug-induced sexual violence, chaotic kind of killer.
The lead investigator saying Cole was strangled and stabbed, a bloody palm print left on a bed sheet, compared to thousands of others, hundreds of interviews, and still no suspects.
We know there's some people out there that have information that they're afraid to share.
What does that tell you, though?
It tells me that it's possibly somebody local, and they're afraid of that person still being in the area.
Head out of town, it's hard to miss the new billboards, the new reward already bringing in useful tips, but a sobering reminder of the mystery that still haunts Fairhaven.
We keep our doors locked at all times now.
One, though, the lieutenant says he's sure he'll solve and put to rest so Myrtle Cole can do the same.
We have made what I would call progress on this case. I am genuinely confident that we will solve this case.
Jennifer Hoff, CARE 11 News.
The lieutenant's also hopeful because he just resubmitted evidence to a crime lab that has such advanced DNA technology now, it could finally create a profile to match the killer. If you have anything to share with investigators, even anonymously, we posted ways to report it at care11.com.